Representative of the last wave of African leaders, Namibian President Hage Geingob was in Luanda for the inauguration of Joao Lourenco and shared with Euronews his vision of current African politics.
Three waves of African leaders.
The first wave was those extraordinary personalities who told us to take arms and fight, like Sekou Touré, Agostinho Neto, and others. The second wave was caught up in, let's say, the confusion of the Cold War. Now, as I say, the third wave of African leaders is asserting the constitutional path. We believe in limiting mandate. Of course, there are those who are going backward, who want to change the constitution to remain in power. But generally, the people want elections. Democratic elections everywhere, but nobody is perfect. Just look at America. I strongly believe in limiting presidential terms, because if you are elected directly by the people, you don't really have anyone to answer to. But if you are elected by parliament, well, that's not what I advocate, but that's what many are doing. During his stay in the neighboring country, Hage Geingob did not forget who supported Namibia during the independence struggle. When President Neto died, José Eduardo dos Santos took power. Our armed struggle was possible because we had our rear base here in Angola, and he was the president who supported us. We were a really good comrade. I knew him personally. He didn't usually travel, but he went to Namibia for my inauguration. We were very close. Now, when it was the funeral, I couldn't travel, and I thought I had to go and pay a last tribute to him.
I have to come and anticipate my last respects.